My dear friends, welcome to Rajasekhar classes on applied data science with Python. This is lecture number 41. In this lecture, we will try to solve one real-time problem. Here, the data set contains 830 entries. This data set collected from mobile phone log spanning a total of 5 months. This data set is in CSV file. We know how to read CSV file. We know how to import that particular CSV file into our Jupyter notebook. My CSV file name is phone_data.csv. I will provide this CSV file in my link comment section. I will upload this particular CSV file in my Google site. After this lecture, just go through my Google site where you can find this corresponding CSV file with which you can work. Anyway, this is not new thing. We know how to read a CSV file. We know how to print a CSV file. Now, I'm printing this CSV file. What is this nature of CSV file? We already discussed. This is the syntax, isn't it? Data pd.read_csv eDrive apply data science with Python. This is my folder where I stored phone_data.csv. I already discussed what is index_call=0. Now, we will try to understand this CSV file. Just see index ranges from 0 to 829. These are known as row labels, I can say, row indices, isn't it? How many rows are there? 0 to 829 means there are 830 rows. How many columns? First column, second column, third column, fourth column, fifth column, sixth column. Therefore, there are 6 columns. What is the first column? First column, is date in which you have date, month, year, and time. 658 is time, isn't it? This is a call log of mobile phone. That's what we were saying, isn't it? This is a time in which that particular call, that may be, we don't know whether it is call or SMS, whatever it may be, this is the time. And duration, 34.429. What is that duration? It is seconds, 34.429 seconds. And data may be item, data may be call, data may be SMS, isn't it? Month, what is this month? Month is billing month. Network, that network may be Vodafone network, network may be Tesco network, that is network, again network type. Anyway, we can understand these are simple and straightforward fields. I explained here. If someone is interested, just read it. It is simple language, date, the date and time of the entry, isn't it? Duration in seconds, that's what I explained. Item, that may be item, may be call, item may be SMS. Your item may be data. It is in simple language. Month means I already told you that is billing month. That is in the form of year and 4Ys and 2Ms, year and month format. Network type, network and network type. Network means what? The mobile network that was called or text. And network type means whether the number being called was mobile or international. International means world or voicemail, landline or any other special number. Anyway, these fields are simple. This language is simple. Anybody can understand this particular fields. Now, we will try to understand this particular. We will try to analyze this particular CSV file. How many rows are there in data set? This is simple. What is the longest phone call? How many seconds of phone calls are recorded in total? How many entries are there for each month? These are the real-time questions, isn't it? We have to analyze your data file in this manner. Number of non-null unique network entries. Get the first entry for each month. Get the first entry for each month, that I already did. Get sum of the durations per month. What is the sum of durations for calls only to each network? How many calls, SMS and data entries in each month? How many calls, text and data are sent per month split by the network type? These are different questions. We will try to answer all these questions with the simple code, isn't it? Yes. Now, anyway, we know how to read this particular data file that I already discussed. What it says, how many rows means just if you read print data, your data is data frame. Just say how many rows are there? 830 rows are there, 6 columns are there. Even if you want to print, you can print number of rows in different ways. For example, data is my data frame, item is, just see, item is column name, this entire table name is data, table in the sense data frame. In that data frame I have item, therefore data of item, just see, this just data of, data is data frame name, that is table name, in which I have variable or column name item, column name I must keep in single quotes, data of item dot count, this dot count method returns number of entries in that particular, in that particular column. How many entries? 830 entries in that particular column means how many rows are there? There are 830 rows. Anyway, we will try to discuss all these things in detailed manner in future classes. There is another question. What is the longest phone call? Longest phone call means what? How will I get, there is a column name duration. Just say here, duration. This is first one, duration 34.429 seconds, 13 seconds, 23 seconds, 4 seconds, 34, it's something like, isn't it? I need a longest phone call. How will I get longest phone call means, it is simply data means data frame name, in which, where is that duration is stored? That duration is stored a column known as duration, just data of duration, dot max means in this particular column, in this duration column, data of duration means I will get this column entries, dot max means it will give maximum value. What is that maximum value? 10528. What does it mean? That is the maximum. What is this 10528? That is number of seconds. These are the number of seconds, isn't it? It is simple. It is simple and straightforward. Now, how many seconds, this also we were discussing. How many seconds of phone calls are recorded in total? How can I find? Means how many seconds of phone calls? How will I get phone calls in this one? This is data frame name. I collected some portion of the table or data frame, just or snippet of that particular data frame. What I need? I need item. In item, I have data, call, SMS like this. But I need call status. Therefore, data is my data frame name, in which item equal to call, isn't it? I need duration of this call. Therefore, I am saying data of duration dot sum. What will I get? I will get some of the calls. Here I have call, here I have call, here I have call, here I have call. Corresponding durations also there. This is duration. Sum of all the durations of this call is 9321.0 seconds. It's self-explanatory. It's not big thing. It's not great thing. How many entries are there for each month? How many months there are? There are 5 months. That's what we were discussing. 2014, 11th month. 2015 first month, 2015 second month, 2015 third month, it's something like that, isn't it? There are 5 months. How will I get data of, data is this data frame name, isn't it? This is data frame name, in which I need month. There is a month column, just see, month dot value counts. Dot value count means what? For each month, how many values are there? It will count. For example, 2014 11th months, there are 230 entries. It's counting month wise, isn't it? It is simple. Anybody can understand. Just see this one, network of non-null unique network entries, number of non-null unique network entries. How will I get? I must go to network. Network is a column name, isn't it? Network is a column name in my data frame. Data is data frame name, network dot n unique means non-null unique entries, dot n unique means you will get non-null unique entries, totally you have 9. Again, get the first entry for each month, isn't it? First I must group this by month, isn't it? Therefore, data is my data frame name, group by, I am grouping this data frame by month, isn't it? Just see. 2004-11, this is 1 month. 2004-12, this is another group. 2015-1, another month. 2015-2, another month. 2015-3, these are months. We are grouping by month. I need, after grouping, I need, what I need? First entry in each month. Dot first means it will always give first entry. Therefore, initially, I must group this data by month. That's what, get first entry for each month. I am grouping by month. dot. If someone is aware of SQL, certainly you can understand what is this group by. I am grouping the data by month wise, means 11th month, 12th month, one, how many entries are there in grouping by month, isn't it? In each month, I am trying to get first entry. Dot first means what will I get? I will get first entry in each month. Get the sum of the durations per month. How will I get sum of the durations per month? First, I must group the data by month, data dot group by month, dot what I need, sum of the duration, therefore duration dot sum. You will get, this is the month, this is sum of the duration. This is the month, this is sum of the duration. This is the month, this is sum of the duration. This is the month, this is the sum of the duration. Isn't it? Just you must group by things, then if you, whichever operation you want, you can perform. Just you can understand, these are simple and straightforward. What is the sum of durations for calls only to each network, isn't it? Just you must go to calls, data item equal to call. What is he asking to each network means you must group it by network. Therefore, I'm grouping it by network. What I need durations. Therefore, duration dot sum. It is self-explanatory. It is not big thing, isn't it? Now, how many calls, SMS and data entries in each month? Therefore, first what I have to do, I must group by what is what I need, month and item. Why? Because in item only I have what is he asking, calls and SMS. Calls and SMS are field values of item. Therefore, I must group month and item. This is month, these are the item values. Again, this is the month, these are the item values. This is the month, these are the item values. What I need, I need count. How many count means dot count. Just see, 107 for call, 29 for data, 94 for SMS. In that manner, it will calculate. This one is simple. Anybody can understand. Just go through it. If you have any difficulty, just keep a comment so that we will try to understand. Let me go to Jupyter notebook. This is data set contains 830 entries. That's what we were discussing. Just see, if I run, what will I get? Just this is the data frame, isn't it? Just see, 830 rows and 7 columns. Why? Because here I have 2 index columns. This is index, there are 2 index columns. Therefore, let me remove one index column. Just let me keep only one column as index column. If I say index underscore call equal 0, that first column will be treated as index column. Therefore, this one is changed. Just see, earlier it was saying 830 rows, 7 columns. Now it says 830 rows and 6 columns. This is the data frame in which you have fields, data, duration, item, month, network, network type. Just try to understand these column names by referring my PPT. Just what it says, how many rows in the data set. Just see how many rows it gives at the bottom of this one, 830 rows. Even you can calculate, data is my data frame name. Item is column name. Just see, this is item. Item is column name. Dot count means it will count number of values in that particular column. Therefore, just let me run this one. If you run, what will you get? You will get 830, means there are 830 rows. Data of duration dot max, this also I discussed. What is my duration? Data is data frame name. Just see, this is my data frame. This is my data frame. In this one, what I need? Duration max. Therefore, I must go to this column. Data of duration dot max means it will give maximum maximum duration, that is 10528, isn't it? How many seconds of phone calls are recorded in total? What does it mean? How will I get phone calls? In data frame data, there is an item. Just see, this is my data frame. There is an item. I have calls here. Just see, the item may be data, item may be calls, item may be SMS, but I need calls, isn't it? Therefore, what am I doing? Data of item equal to call. I need duration. Therefore, data of duration dot sum means it will give sum of the duration, that is 92321.0 seconds. What it says, how many entries are there for each month? First, I must go to month. How will I go to month? Data of month, value underscore counts. it will give, what will it give? It will give month-wise count entries. That's what it says, 2014, 2015, first month, 2014, 12th month. There are 5 months, first, second, you can understand, isn't it? Non-null unique entries means N unique. Where you need non-null unique entries, network. First, I must go to data frame in which I have network. What is he asking? Number of non-null unique network entries. Therefore, data of network dot N unique means you will get unique entries. There are 9 non-null unique entries in a column known as network. Get the first entry for each month. I must group this data by month. Therefore, I am grouping this data. Data dot group by month means this data will be grouped by month in which I need first entry. There is a method known as first dot first means it will give first entry in each month. Therefore, 2014 11th month first entry is this one. 2014 12th month, this is first entry, 13 11, this you can understand, isn't it? Now what it says, get the sum of durations per month. First I must group the data by month. Therefore, data dot group by month, sum of the duration means duration dot sum. Therefore, it will give sum of the durations for each month. Get the number of dates or entries in each month. How will I get? First I must group that by month, according to that in which I must count date. This is date. Just see, there is a just see, this is date. There is a column known as date. Just see, date dot count, isn't it? Why, what is my original table? This is date. Just see, this is original, my original data frame. That's what I'm saying, date dot count, it will give count. Just see, there it is. Yes, this is date dot count. Therefore, 2014 11, how many are there? 230 entries. This is similar to previous one. These are the self-explanatory data of item equal to call group by network. This also I discussed in my presentation. This anybody can understand. Here I am grouping by month and item. After that I am counting. Therefore, each just see, I am grouping by month. 2014-11 and this is month, isn't it? Am I not grouping by month? This is month and item. This is the item in 2014 11th month. What are these are the items? Item values, call, data, SMS, date dot count means I am counting all this. How will I this? I already discussed what is count. I already discussed what is date, isn't it? Just go through it. Certainly you can understand. It's not a big thing. Anybody can understand. It is self-explanatory. Maybe I am repeating things many times. Let me stop here itself. If you have any difficulty, just keep a comment so that we will try to understand. Thank you very much.